Excellent performance against Robert the Ghost Guerrero. How would you rate your performance?
I give myself a B, man. You know, he fought a little different than I expected him to. I thought he wanted to trade. He didn't really want to trade early on. You know, he let me control the pace. He let me back him up for someone who thought I was going to run all night. You know, and, you know, I'm happy, man. At the end of the day, I wanted to be aggressive for 6 rounds. Then I wanted to box for 6 rounds. And that was the game plan that I went in originally, and we, for the most part, we stuck to that game plan. And it was a great fight. The fans almost after every single round were standing up and applauding, man, all night. So I know they're happy. That makes me happy.
Yeah, and speaking of the fans, like I said, you had the best performance, no doubt about it. I was surprised, too, that Guerrero, he challenged you to stand there. You jumped after him. He was a lot more passive. Do you feel with some fans, sometimes you damn if you do, damn if you don't, because they complain about the Bundu fight. This time you had a flawless performance, and you still had some people, you know, that was criticizing you. And I think it was like only one round that you moved, which was like the 11th round.
Put it this way, man. They don't sign my paychecks. I ain't worried about how they feel, you know. It's my job to go in there and get the victory, and we did that. And for the most part, we pleased most people. And, you know, if you please most people, it's hard to feel unsatisfied. You know, you can't make everybody happy. You know what I'm saying? Even the dude working at McDonald's, you know what I'm saying? He's trying to get your order right, but sometimes he don't. You know what I mean? You can't make everybody happy, man. You know, they say that I'm beatable. I never said that I'm unbeatable. I just said, you gotta beat me. Come beat me. You know what I'm saying? You better bring your A game too if you wanna beat me. And keep them hands up, because I'm gonna hurt you. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is, man. You know, I'm keep one time Thurman. I'm blessed. I'm so happy to be where I am in the world of boxing. I'm blessed. I'm so happy that NBC is back into the sport of boxing. You know, we kicked off this show on prime time. So at the end of the day, man, I mean, I'm not going nowhere. I'm welterweight champion of the world. You guys are going to see tremendous performances of me for years and years and years to come.
Keith, we spoke before. You, during the fight, the third round, it was a headbutt. Your head started swelling. Watching it, you could sense the pain that you were going through. Can you describe the pain and how 6 days later you look like you didn't even fight?
You know, it's hard to really describe pain, you know, especially when you're in the ring and you got a lot of adrenaline. All that I can say is that, you know, you, to a degree, it was sensitive, you know. When they throw the ice on there, when they apply pressure, you know, it had an ache, you know. At the end of the day, you almost feel like a little kid with a boo where they grab it and you're like, ah. You know, but you push through it, man. My focus wasn't to focus on the pain that my body was experiencing, but understanding that there's a man that wants to challenge me, you know, and I'm here to challenge him. And we will challenge each other till that final bell is rung. And that's what happened that night against Robert Guerrero.
Millions of people tuned in. Keith Thurman and Guerrero was an amazing fight. You have brand new fans now that never saw. How's your life changed in the last 6 days since that fight?
At the end of the day, nothing really has changed. You know, I've been traveling.
No, more Twitter followers? More people recognize you at the airport? Or
I went to the airport once. We flew over here quick. It was one way. You know, I checked into my hotel and the butler knows me. You know what I'm saying? You know, the dude carrying my bags know me. And, you know, they said congrats on the fight. So, you know, you get a little bit more love. I haven't checked my Twitter followers, but it's probably updated a little bit. But you know, at the end of the day, man, I've just been resting. You know, I'm like I always say, man, I'm blessed. I'm really happy to be world champion. Happy that I was able to do what I wanted to do and make a statement out of Robert Guerrero, and we did that.
For EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.